Women need to feel seen. What do I mean by that? That you see them for who they really are, all that they are, the good, the bad, the ugly, whatever it is, without judgment, that you see them. You know, when someone sees you for who you are as a man, they see the sacrifices you've made, and they actually see you and recognize you, it feels friggin' good, doesn't it? So she needs to feel seen. And she's like, no, that's, you don't get it. I'd be like, well, what don't I get? Because I just repeated everything you said. What she wanted to know is what she meant behind the words that she was saying, that I understood her feelings. I understood her intent behind her words. I have a wife who feels on top of the world. She feels like she's being a great mom and being recognized for it. And so she's feeling desired by her husband. Guess who gets what they want? Me. I get what I want. Hey guys, welcome back to the TPM show. So my birthday is coming up, and a birthday at our age, right, is one of those things that's not that big of a deal. But we're also doing a barn raising here at the TPM ranch. So we have a 106-acre ranch where we have events that are very private so our men can come here. And during our barn raising, men that are involved in the movement volunteer, we have a lot of fun. I mean, a lot of fun. But we also work really hard. We're hardworking men. And we build this area up, this property up, so that it can be a sanctuary for men like you who come through our program to come into and get the healing, the growth that they deserve. And one guy said, hey, Doug, I know it's your birthday coming up, and I want to get you a gift, you know, and he told me he was going to get me a bottle of whiskey, a very expensive bottle of whiskey. Very good for him, right? It was really nice. And he asked, hey, what can I get your wife? And that was really cool of him. He's just a nice guy, wants to show respect, and I think it's super cool. But it got me thinking, like, what's the best gift you can get your wife? And as I was thinking about that, like, what is the best gift a man can give his wife? And that's the gift of being seen, heard, and desired. Those three things. As much as I want my wife to get the bottle of whiskey so I can drink it with her, really, the thing that any of us can give our wives is this ability of being seen, heard, and desired, right? We know women need this. Women need this to feel safe. They need this to feel fulfilled. So again, I'm going to say those three things again. I'm going to say them a lot during this show, so you're going to get used to it. But I want it to be ingrained in your soul. Women need to feel seen. What do I mean by that? It's not just looked at. They need to be felt that you actually get them, right? That you see them for who they really are, all that they are, the good, the bad, the ugly, whatever it is, without judgment, that you see them, right? You know when someone sees you for who you are as a man, they see the sacrifices you've made, they see all that you've done for your family, all that you do for your community, your church, your synagogue, whatever it may be, your place of worship. Maybe it's seeing yourself for all that you do for your little league baseball team, whatever it may be. When they actually see you and recognize you, it feels friggin' good, doesn't it? They see the real you, not the facade. So she needs to feel seen. She also needs to feel heard. And heard doesn't mean listened to, it means understood. Very big difference. I remember in counseling one time with my wife, marriage counseling, early on, we were trying to figure out her stuff, and it didn't work. I would sit there and she'd say, he doesn't listen to me. And I would go, look, I can repeat back verbatim everything you said last 5 minutes. And I start to repeat it back. And she's like, no, that's, you don't get it. I'd be like, well, what don't I get? Because I just repeated everything you said, you know, and I was showing how smart I was and how much I was listening, and I was active listening, as they say. That's not it. Right? What she wanted to know is what she meant behind the words that she was saying, that I understood her feelings. I understood her intent behind her words. So that's seen and heard. Then there's desired. Desired is that she wants to feel like my woman. Yeah, like my woman. I had to think about that for a second. She wants to feel as if she's my woman, my queen, that she's the only woman that I want. She wants to feel desired by me, like I want her. I want to ravage her body. I want to be with her. And she wants the ability to push me away or accept, right? So seen, heard, and desired. This is by far the best gift you can give your wife, guys. By far the best. You know, and so in doing so, how do we go about this process? Well, we've talked in previous episodes about the hidden motives technique, the clean slate method, the live like a king system. Those three things are what make up what we call the triad of connection. Those three things are by far the best. Go back and listen to the hidden motives technique. But it's really about getting into your wife's world. So something, I'm a guy, right? So I have project management software for business, but I also have a project for my life. And being a guy, I forget things, right? So I have to set alarms and ideas. And here's a question to you. I'll ask you this question. Just answer right away, yes or no. First answer that comes up. Do you know the books your wife is reading right now? Audible or whatever, yes or no, right? Do you know the books she's read over the last 6 months? Do you know the shows she watched? Do you know the social media channels she's on? Do you know her best friend? Do you know her best friend locally? You get the idea. If you've answered no to any of these, and the most common one is books read, most guys don't, then that's an issue. So what I've done is on my project management software, I have a repeating task to check what books my wife's reading, to check on these things so I can get into my wife's world so she can feel seen, heard, and desired, right? These are little tricks that I have to put in place, techniques to allow myself to be front of mind. Because, you know, we always think that our partner, our wife, is the same person that she was last time that we really saw her, right? Which for some of you guys is going to be not till you got married. You thought your wife 10 years ago is the same woman. That's not true. You're not the same man. She's definitely not the same woman, right? And the fact is your wife isn't the same woman she was a week ago, let alone the way she was 10 years ago. So you need to get into her world to really allow her to be seen, to recognize her. In fact, just the other day, my wife, I sent her a message and said, hey, I really appreciate, so what she did, I'll set the scene and just let you guys know how I'm doing it. And I'm not doing it perfectly by any means, gentlemen, but I'm doing the best that I can. I'm getting better at this. Is my wife took our four-year-old daughter and my son, who's six, took her to a Waldorf school. So if you're not familiar with Waldorf, basically a private school for little kids, a Waldorf school for an introduction. And we want our daughter to go there because we think she'll thrive there. She's in a Montessori school, and then she's going to go to public school. Anyway, we think she'll thrive in this Waldorf school. My son went there. He thrived. My daughter's struggling right now at the school she's at. She's only four. So my wife is exhausted, but she ends up taking the kids there. I also get free rein of the house. I needed some time, some space to myself. She knew that. She said, hey, I'm taking the kids to this introduction. The house is yours. I left you some food. So I thought for a second, and there was something she did that upset me. But I thought about it, and I sent her a text, and I said, hey, babe, thanks so much for taking the kids to this Waldorf school. This is one of those small intangible things that you do that make our family better, and I appreciate that. And she sent me back the heart emoji, the pray emoji, and the tear emoji. And you know, later on, she was like, that meant the world to me that you saw that I do these things, right? Because she's like, oh my gosh, my husband sees me. He sees the fact that I'm taking the kids to this event. Yes, it's fun for my wife. There'll be other mothers there, maybe fathers there, but definitely other mothers there that she knows, that she'll be able to socialize with. But this is her role. She's a mom. And so I'm recognizing her contribution to our family. And it meant the world to her, right? She's being now seen. Then she came back and emptied her berries, right? She told me about everything that was happening. She was excited to share all the things, all the details. And as you do as a man, if you want her to be heard, is you listen. What else? What else? You encourage her to empty that berry basket. If you don't know what I'm talking about, we've done a bunch of podcasts on emptying the berries. Super important, guys. I'm not going to go into it right now, but it's super important you understand this concept at a core level. So she empties the berries and she's going. She's super excited and I'm listening to her. So now she's felt seen. Now she's feeling heard. And all she has to do is feel desired. And I've got the perfect formula for giving my wife everything she wants. And here's the secret. She's going to give me everything I want as well, right? Reciprocity. So if as long as I show that I'm desiring her afterwards, you know, and all I have to do is say something like, hey, let's put a little show on for the kids. And why don't you and I go into the bedroom and continue this conversation? Give her a little wink and a kind of a dirty tone, if you will. My wife jumps up, puts a show on for the kids right away. And she, you know, she doesn't run, but she walks very quickly into the bedroom because she's excited. She's felt seen. She's felt heard. You know, so it's love and appreciation. And now she's getting the desired portion coming into it. And guess who gets what they want? Me. I get what I want. I have a wife who feels on top of the world. She feels like she's being a great mom and being recognized for it, right? She feels like her husband is the amazing man, right? Regardless if I am or not, she's feeling that way at the time. And so she's feeling desired by her husband, which then, you know, makes her desiring. She wants to desire me, which is crazy as that sounds, right, guys? But she is, and then we have great sex. And then we both feel connected. we come out of that, you know, of that intimacy, that moment of intimacy, and my wife and I are connected and bonded more. You guys know how that is. You're just more bonded after you have loving, connected sex. And now the kids' show is over, right? We turn it off. And the kids are now in a household that is has an energy of love, an energy of connection. Because I gave my wife the best gift. The gift of being seen, heard, and desired. Right? Now this applies for all women. Also applies for men, by the way. Not the desired part, guys. I don't need to prefer the bottle of whiskey or something else mailed to me. although I appreciate that. But men also want to be seen and heard. So that's important too. You're listening to the guys around you and you're really understanding who they are and what's going on for them. Because most men don't feel like. We feel like, you know, we're living a life of quiet desperation. I don't feel that way anymore, but I did in the past and I realize that most men do. So what's the best gift you can give your wife? Whether it be Mother's Day that's coming up, whether it be her birthday, whether it be the holidays, or whether it just be a Tuesday. Give her the gift of being seen, heard, and desired. If you're not sure how to do that, jump into one of our communities and ask questions. Guys, life's too short to be average. I'm going to keep saying that over and over again. You do not want to be average. If I came up to you and said, hey, do you want to be an average businessman? Do you want to be an average father? Do you want to be an average husband? You would say, hell no, Doug, I don't. I don't want to. Then great. Stop being average. Step up to the game, boys. It's time to play. I'm in your corner, and I want the best for you. I'll see you next time on the TPM show.